All right, you guys were asking for it. You wanted to see it. This is the behind the scenes of how we made the Corrupted Tarot by Wyrmwood Kickstarter video. We're gonna break it down, we're gonna show you how we did it, but first, let's play the video one more time. Okay, so before I start breaking down some shots, I want to highlight the product a little bit first. This is very new for Wyrmwood. We've never had a tarot deck, meaning I've never shot a tarot deck before. I typically shoot dice vaults, tabletop trays, tables. Never shot a two-dimensional piece of paper with some cool artwork on it. And because of that, I knew I was going to need some type of prop or theme to spice up these visuals and bring the cards to life. And I was struggling to think of something until I came across a video. It was about an artist named Eric Mespley. He creates these brilliant alien-like mesmerizing art pieces and uses a crazy looking black fluid. That black fluid is exactly what we used, and that black fluid is called ferrofluid. And the thing that's so cool about this fluid is it's magnetic. Little history lesson on ferrofluid. It was developed by a NASA engineer in the 1960s. And it was created for use inside spaceships in zero gravity. Because think about it, if you have fuel inside a gas tank where you're in zero gravity, the fuel's not gonna go to the engine where it needs to go. And what they did is they added little magnetic nanoparticles inside the fluid, and that's what allows it to be transported from one spot to another. And as soon as I saw this, I knew it'd be perfect for this Corrupted Kickstarter, because it looks corrupted. It's called ferrofluid, it should be called corrupted fluid. And when it's creeping, crawling across the artwork, it almost gives the feeling that this liquid is corrupting the tarot. It kind of feels like venom to me in that way. And so I bought a small bottle of it and I started messing around with it and experimenting, and I'll just cut to some B-roll. It's so cool, it's so fun. As soon as you introduce a magnet next to it, it spikes up. The further away you have the magnet, the larger the spikes are. The closer you have the magnet, the smaller the spikes are. And what those spikes are is the liquid following the magnet field of the magnet. All right, so now let's show you how we did it. First things first, I did not shoot on these cards. I was actually shooting photo prints. So I brought in my photo printer and printed out some large, high resolution prints of the art, and I shot on those. And then I grabbed a small glass tank, flipped it on its side, and laid the artwork on top. And then underneath, I can reach in and hold up a magnet underneath the artwork. So then I squeeze a few drops of ferrofluid on the artwork, and I bring my magnet underneath and bring it to the ferrofluid, and you'll see it spikes up. And then I can drag it around the artwork and create little pathways. For some shots, I would stick the magnet in one spot and then drop the ferrofluid maybe a few inches away from the magnet, so that as soon as the ferrofluid hit the paper, it would pool right to the magnet. Then there was a shot of, what was it, the 7 of Wands and 9 of Wands, I think. The way I did that was dragging the ferrofluid completely across the vines. After that shot, I brought it into Premiere Pro. If you guys are taking note, I love masks. I use them all the time. So this was another simple mask where I masked the outline of the vine so that the ferrofluid only stays within the outline of the vine. So that was it. That was it for the ferrofluid. Just kind of drop it on the artwork, drag it around, create some cool effects. Now the last shot I want to go over is the crystal ball shot at the end of the video. I was excited to shoot that for a while, and then I went to shoot it, and it was actually easier than I thought. So the way we did it was by getting a crystal ball, gluing it to the stand that it came with, wrapping that up and tying it to a C-stand. And then one important thing I figured out that I had to do was put a little piece of white paper behind the crystal ball, because this is what the crystal ball looks like with the paper, and this is what it looks like without. Then I grabbed some black acrylic paint and just drizzled it on the crystal. And then in post, we of course flip it 180 degrees, and then it looks like the black liquid is fighting against gravity to corrupt this crystal ball. And in order to get the levitating spinning deck, I created a tarot lollipop. I glued the deck together, drilled a hole into it, put a dowel into it, and then attached this to the screwdriver so that I could get a nice, slow, consistent spin. After that, I brought it into After Effects to do a simple wire removal where I can then, you know, remove this dowel. And the reason why I like this shot so much and why I think it's a perfect ending to this video is I think it encapsulates the theme of this entire Kickstarter. The crystal ball represents, I guess, like tarot and like divination, and it's pure. It's got this pure gold hue, and then our corrupted tarot deck spins towards it, and as it gets closer, this pure crystal ball gets overtaken by this corrupted black liquid. That was my favorite shot. Speaking of favorite shots, I'd love to know what your favorite shot was, so leave it down in the comments below. And now it is time for Matt to break down his sick animation at the end of the video. Take it away, Matt.
What's up, everybody? I made an animation and I'm gonna show you how I done did it. Let's go. We're starting off in After Effects, as always. Started off with a very basic, simple shape, the circle. As you can see here, I can move the position, I can move the rotation, and I can even change the depth of the object. And so I use this simple shape to give me an idea of what this transformation might look like. Once I was happy with the way that the animation looked in After Effects, I brought it into Photoshop. Now this is where it got real tedious. Got my tablet, got my pen, and I went in frame by frame and hand drew and carved out these shapes to make them look exactly how I wanted them to. I had to have the coin turn into the cup and then turn into a wand and then turn into the sword. And it took a really long time, but I think it was totally worth it. I brought down the frame rate a little bit, and it gives it this really nice traditional hand-drawn animated look. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and thank you for backing the Kickstarter.
Hello. My name is Bobby. I was the VP of this project. I did and edited the less impressive half of the video. So when this project rolled around, I knew that I wanted to do the video different this time. So what always ends up happening is JV will create this insane masterpiece, and then it transitions to Ed and Doug. Now, I love Ed and Doug, and they've done this thing where they, in a quirky way, kind of thank everybody, and it's never really been taken too seriously, trying to be down to earth and not have it be this super polished thing. But in our last campaign for Hexy Time, I ended up making a video that was a bit more straight to camera, telling everybody exactly what they needed to know. I wanted that type of video to be in the actual main Kickstarter video. I actually think that this is the best video package that we've put on Kickstarter. JV killed it per usual. Matt killed it per usual. I tried to keep up with these guys. How do I end it, JV? You gave me a fucking hell of a task, being like, oh, by the way, just end the whole thing without knowing anything else about the video. I'm gonna be like, and we'll see you next time. Whoa! And we'll see you guys next time. And we'll see you guys next time. We hope that you guys enjoyed it too, and we'll see you guys on the next one.